What's up, guys? Welcome back to another Stay Fresh production. And welcome back to another Fragrances of the Week. This is week three. And decided to change things up. I was getting a lot of feedback from you guys. A lot of you guys said you would rather see me on camera. So here I am, back in more of a usual format. I am in the process of trying to find a way to make these videos more interesting and more unique. I'd like to incorporate my music more into the channel somehow. I'm still trying to find ways to do that without it coming off as being kitschy or gimmicky or anything like that. So hopefully some new developments will be on its way to the channel soon in regards to putting my music here, because I would like to do more of that. So if you don't know how Fragrances of the Week works, if this is your first time tuning in, what we do is I tell you guys the fragrances that I've been wearing for the past 7 days from last Friday up until now, which is Thursday, the day I'm shooting it. And you'll see this video tomorrow, which is going to be Friday, June the 7th. So let's start off with last Friday. I started things off for the day with this fragrance from the House of Parfums Vintage. This is X Batch Intense. This is one of their newer releases. I'm really growing into this one, to be honest. When I first smelled it, I immediately preferred the original X Batch. But I think maybe the fragrance has settled a bit with time, so now I really enjoy it. It's fresh, it's uplifting, it's sweet and fruity and juicy. So I wore it on Friday morning last week, and I really enjoyed it. So that's X Batch Intense. The next thing I wore on Friday was Creed Original Vetiver. You might recognize this decant if you saw my video comparing Mugler Cologne to Creed Original Vetiver, which I did a couple years ago. Great scent, fresh and clean and uplifting. Super, super clean. It's fresh and soapy and clean and very representative of the color of the fragrance itself. The way it looks is the way it smells. So that's what I wore for the day on Friday last week. On Saturday, I wore two fragrances as well. I pulled this one out, which I haven't worn in a couple weeks. This is Creed Royal Water, and I'm still really loving this stuff. This is so good. You got citrus and basil in here. There's mint in here, and then I think there's even some ambergris. Just super fresh and clean, a little aquatic as per the name. It has a bit of a vintage gentleman's quality to it. There's a part of this that does kind of remind me of fragrances like Bois de Portugal from Creed as well. It's a little mature in a way, just in the background, but it really just comes off in the air, very bright and fresh and inviting, perfect for the summer, and you'll see this featured a whole lot more in the next few months. Later on, that day on Saturday, I've been loving this fragrance lately. I put this on and I really, really enjoyed it. And that's L'Homme from Yves Saint Laurent. This is a staple in my collection. This is a classic, really, truly a classic. Never, ever, ever get tired of this. Fresh and sweet and creamy. You got vetiver in here. There's some ginger. There's an apple nuance, but I don't think there's actually apple in here. Really, really beautiful scent. Timeless in my opinion. Always enjoy wearing this. And we'll be doing a whole lot more so this upcoming summer. All right, on Sunday last week, which was, I believe, June the 2nd, just wore one fragrance, and that was Elysium Parfum Cologne from the House of Raja Parfum. This is a wonderful scent. I do have a review of it, which you can check out. And the review says it all, but there's a lot to this fragrance, but it comes off smelling kind of simple, but very sophisticated. It's complex, but it's not complicated. That's the best way I can put it. Fresh and clean, easy to wear. Grapefruit, vetiver, juniper. There's some musks in there. There's florals, woods. Everything is in this fragrance. Everything, except for the kitchen sink. I really enjoy it, and it was a perfect day to wear it. It was nice and hot, so great day to wear. Elysium Parfum Cologne. On Monday, June the 3rd, pulled out this classic, another classic from the House of Yves Saint Laurent. This is La Nuit de L'Homme. This is probably my favorite scent that I wore this week. Every time I put it on, I just feel elevated. I feel sexy, you know? And again, I don't really say that word often, but this stuff does it for me. I love it. I put it on and I'm just like, oh, I know I smell good.
Smell me, world.
I didn't get any compliments with it, but I still love it. That's La Nuit de L'Homme. Later on Monday, I pulled out another banger, another staple in my collection, at the barber's from the house of Martin Margiela. Man, this, oof. If you like barbershop style scents, this is one to check out. If you want to know more about it, I reviewed it not long ago. This is a great scent, one to learn about. And again, you can do so by watching my review. This one's a compliment getter. So that's at the barber's. All right, this past Tuesday, this was a special day for me. It was a very long day. I actually had a job interview that day. And I went by Nordstrom just to check things out and see what was new and do some sniffing. And I also had a concert with my students, one of my jazz bands that I taught this year at a high school. We had our final concert, so it was a very long day, very eventful day. I started it off and spent most of it wearing this one, Reflection Man from Momwage. This one recently made my top Beast Mode fragrance list, which you can check out up here. It lasted me 10 hours easy with solid projection for almost half of that time. I just went 2 to 3 sprays and it was gorgeous, really nice. I could get wafts around me all day. Now, it was pretty warm that day, so I was a little worried, but it actually worked out. I had never really worn Amouage in the heat because I felt like it was just too strong, but it actually did well, mainly because I think I spent a lot of time outdoors, okay? Now, by the time we got to the evening, I decided to switch things up and I put on this little sample that I actually got from Nordstrom. This is Rose 31 from the house of Le Labo. And this actually came from a wonderful sales associate that I met at Nordstrom. His name was Brian. So Brian, if you're watching this, shout out to you. And he gave me a number of samples of which I'll be discovering. One of them is Rose 31. And wow, this is a gorgeous rose scent. If you don't like rose fragrances, you need to check this out. Yes, you heard me right. This is one of the rose fragrances out there that is great for those who don't really like rose because it is not super upfront, heady, floral rose. There's a whole lot more to it. I'm not going to try to dissect it because I haven't spent much time with it and I haven't really researched it that much. So that's all I'm going to say. I just really enjoyed wearing Le Labo Rose 31 for the evening on Tuesday. Wednesday, this was a special day as well because it was my last day of teaching for the school year, which I really needed because it was getting exhausting. But now I'm happy to say that school year's over, got the summer break, and now we're looking forward to next year. And this is what I wore for that day. I wore it the whole day, and it lasted me a good 7 hours. John Varvatos Vintage, yet another staple. This is such a beautiful scent. Check out my review. I do my best to put this fragrance into words. I don't think I did it justice. I'm not gonna say anything about it. Watch the review. This is John Varvatos Vintage. That's what I wore yesterday on the 5th of June. And on the 6th, I had another interview today that went very well. And I'm not gonna say exactly what the position is that I was applying for, but I will say that it is in the realm of fragrances, which I'm very excited about. And I wore La Nuit de L'Homme yet again, second time this week, and I did not regret it. It was just as great as the first time. Yes, I'm going to smell it again, even though I already smelled it. Beautiful, kind of cakey, in my opinion. Sweet, fresh bergamot, lavender, cardamom. That was La Nuit. I wore that today. Now, make sure you stay tuned. On Monday, I got a very special video coming. Diane is coming back to the channel, and we're going to do some first impressions of some very fun fragrances. So make sure you don't miss that. I never say this, but maybe hit that bell. Turn the bell notifications on so you know when I drop the video, you get a notification. So it comes straight to you and you can tune in and enjoy it right then and there. So that's all I'm gonna say. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. Peace. I'll see you guys in the next one.